I hate her. Emily, when did you get back? What kind of greeting is that? How about Emily? How was your day? Well, you didn't give me a chance to say that because you came in all angry. What's wrong? Nothing. Well, it doesn't seem like nothing. Oh, for goodness sake, if you have to know, Joss and I had a fight. You and Joss had a fight? Isn't that what he said? Yeah, you did say that. I just wanted to make sure I heard you right. Well, you did. Well, what were you guys fighting over? You guys are in fifth grade. What could he possibly be fighting over? She knows that I have two dolls. And Josh said it's time for me to grow up and to get rid of the dolls. Well, do you think you need to get rid of them? No, I don't. But if that's what she wants, Emily, you shouldn't have to change for anybody. I know, but maybe she's right. Maybe I should just get rid of the stupid dolls. Emily, are you sure that's what you want to do? No, but it's what Joss wants. Emily.
And hoping you would come around. I've been giving out chances every time, and all you do is let me down. And it's taken me this long, baby, but I figured you out. And you're thinking we'll be fine again, but not this time around. You don't have to come.
I hate seeing you like this. Fine, you don't have to look at me. Emily, I'm serious. Why do you care so much about what this Joss person says? I mean, she just moved here. I know, but she's so cool. She wears the coolest clothes. She skates, boards, and surfs. She even won a surfing contest. What am I good at? Well, what does that have to do with your dolls? Are you getting rid of them because Joss told you to? She said she wouldn't be my friend if I played with dolls. Well, I think you know that if somebody expects you to change something you love and to stop doing what you love, do you really think that's a real friend? You know, Mom will be home from work at 10. She'd probably say the same exact thing you're saying. Jeez, it must get passed down. Now I'm going to wind up saying it to my daughter. Emily, I'm serious. And you're right, Mom probably would tell you the same thing. But I'm your sister, we're closer in age. So don't you trust me? A little more than you trust Mom? You just don't get it. Of course I do. I used to wear dresses a lot. So? So my friends would make fun of me. I was around your age. When I was in third grade. And my friends have told me, if you wear dresses, and they weren't even casual dresses, they were like frilly and everything. You mean, Mom made you wear frilly dresses? Well, sort of. I couldn't walk or talk at that point. What? Why? Did you hurt yourself or something? I was born very prematurely.
You were?
Yeah, you don't remember because you were just a very little kid. But when I was eight, or when I was born, rather, I only weighed a pound. They didn't think I would make it. They thought I would never walk or talk or do anything on my own. Well, you do now. Exactly. But even when I started talking on my own, I couldn't dress myself. And I guess Mom wanted me to stay the little girl she always loved. So she made me wear frilly dresses, jumpers, Mary Janes. It was embarrassing. But then I realized the same thing I'm telling you. What's that? You don't have to change for somebody who isn't a real friend. Because real friends like you for who you are. Think about what I said, okay? Okay. You can start by picking up your dolls and putting them back on the chair. There's nothing to be ashamed of. Yeah? Hey, your sister called me and told me that I had to talk to you. Okay. What do you want? Well, what I wanted to know is, have you decided to give up dolls and be friends with me? Because you know we can't be friends if we play with dolls. So why don't you put that thing away, and also the other thing, put it in your closet, and let's go to the mall and try on clothes. And we're not going to stop at the toy store either. Sit down, Joss. Fine, but can you at least get the doll away from me? She's giving me the creeps. Fine, I'll put her on my other side, but I'm not throwing her. Look, why do you have to play with dolls? You know what, Joss? I'm proud of playing with dolls. It's just who I am. And I can't have you take that away from me. And I'm happy for who I am. I don't care what you think. And if you were really my friend, you would accept the fact that I play with dolls. You don't have to agree with it, but you should at least respect it. But I'm happy how I am. And I don't need you as a friend. In fact, who even needs you as a friend? You're not a nice girl, and I'm glad not to have you as a friend anymore. Come on, you want to be my friend? No, not at all. Not anymore. Because you don't accept people for who they are. You're going to regret this. No, I don't think I will. So I'm being ditched by a doll lover? I guess so. You know where the door is. Don't let it hit you in the butt on the way out. Ugh. Oh, Felicity, you fell off my bed. Hey, I just saw Joss leave, and I heard you guys fighting in our room. Are you okay? I'm fine. I just realized that a real friend wouldn't criticize me for playing with dolls. I don't plan on stopping soon. You shouldn't have to stop. If it makes you happy, then keep doing what makes you happy. Thanks, Sage. Well, come on, let's forget all about Joss. Or we can go on the computer. We can even go on the American Girl website to play games if you want. Really? Yeah, come over here. Let's go on my computer. Okay. Here, sit down here. And I'll log on to the computer. Great. Oh my gosh, they have the new video of the Girl of the Year. There's like a whole movie on her. Can we watch it? Of course we can. I even want to watch it. Great. Okay, hold on. Let me push play on it. Okay, let's watch it. Oh my gosh, that girl's so pretty. I want to get that doll soon. Maybe you will. What do you mean? My lips are sealed. Whatever, I'll find out eventually. Yes, you will. Now shut up, let's watch the movie. Okay? Are you sure you're okay, though? Yeah, I am. Great.
And hoping you would come around. I've been given giving out chances every time, and all you do is let me down. And it's taken me this long, baby, but I figured you out. And you're thinking we'll be fine again, but not this time.